In this video, we will discuss how to carry out hypothesis tests or t-tests in origin. The hypothesis tests include one sample t-test, pair sample t-test, two sample t-test, and two sample test for variance. First, we will perform one sample t-test. This is the origin data file in which a manufacturer wants to check the average diameter of nuts, which must be 21 mm in diameter, and its standard deviation. Out of all the nuts, 100 nuts have been picked randomly, and their diameters have been reported here. The average diameters can be measured easily arithmetically. However, the standard deviation will remain unknown. Therefore, the one sample t-test in origin will be performed to determine the average diameter and its standard deviation. To perform the one sample t-test, select column A, go to Statistics, Hypothesis Testing, One Sample T-Test, open dialog. From the prompted menu, in the input tab, under input data form, raw is to be selected. In input, click the arrow and select column A. In the T-Test for mean tab, set test mean to 21 and alternate hypothesis. Select the first option, which covers two-sided test, check confidence interval, and set confidence level in percent to 95. Rest of the tabs will remain at their default values. Click OK to perform the statistics. The calculations have been displayed in the new sheet. Let's discuss the results. The descriptive statistics table shows the sample size, mean, standard deviation, and standard error for the variable. The sample mean 21.00459 is comparatively little bigger than the hypothesis mean 21, and the standard error of the mean is 0.00156. From the t-test table, the t-statistic 2.9437 and the associated p-value 0.00404 provide evidence that the average diameter of screw nuts is significantly different with 21 at the level. The confidence interval indicates that it is 95% confident that the true mean of the variable lies within the interval 21.0015 to 21.00769. Pair sample t-test. Second, we will perform pair sample t-test. This is the origin data file in which abrasion resistance between two kinds of tires will be compared. The randomly picked tires of the two types are grouped into 8 pairs. To perform the pair sample t-test, select both columns A and B, go to Statistics, Hypothesis Testing, Pair Sample T-Test, open dialog. From the prompted menu, in the input tab under input data form, raw is to be selected. In input, in the first data range, select column A, while in the second data range, select column B. In the t-test for mean tab, set test mean to 0. Rest of the tabs will remain at their default values. Click OK to perform the statistics. The calculations have been displayed in the new sheet. Let's discuss the results. From the t-test table, the t-statistic 2.83119 and the associated p-value 0.02536 indicate that the difference between the two means is significant, that is, the two types of tires have different abrasion resistance. Two sample t-test. Third, we will perform two sample t-test. This is the origin data file in which a physician is evaluating the effect of two kinds of soporifics. To test the effectiveness of these two medicines, 20 insomniac patients are randomly selected. Half took medicine A and the other half took medicine B. The extended sleeping time were recorded after each patient took the medicine. To determine whether the two medicines have different effect on patients, we could carry out a two-sample independent t-test with the following steps. Select both columns A and B, go to Statistics, Hypothesis Testing, Two-Sample T-Test, Open Dialog. From the prompted menu, in the Input tab, under Input Data Form, Raw is to be selected. In Input, in the first data range, select column A, while in the second data range, select column B. Rest of the tabs will remain at their default values. Click OK to perform the statistics. The calculations have been displayed in the new sheet. Let's discuss the results. The t-test procedure automatically provides two tests of the mean difference. One is based on the assumption that the variances of two samples are equal and the other is not. In this example, both tests indicate that there is no significant evidence for a difference in CAVR effects between medicine A and medicine B. P-values are 0.0738 and 0.074, both greater than the significance level 0.05. Two-sample test for variance. Now, on the same data, we will perform two-sample test for variance. Go to Statistics, Hypothesis Testing, Two-Sample Test for Variance, Open Dialog. From the prompted menu, in the Input tab, under Input Data Form, Raw is to be selected. In Input, in the first data range, select column A, while in the second data range, select column B. Rest of the tabs will remain at their default values. Click OK to perform the statistics. The calculations have been displayed in the new sheet. Let's discuss the results. According to the results, p-value 0.77181, which is greater than 0.05, therefore, it fails to reject null hypothesis, so two population variances are not significantly different. Thanks for watching the video and stay tuned for the forthcoming videos in the statistical data analysis series.